In this video, we're asked to plot the polar curve r of theta equals 4 cosine 2 theta, and this is known as a polar rose or a rose curve. And we're going to do this by plugging in some special angles of theta. So if you've seen my other video on plotting a rose curve by plugging points in, I was extremely thorough about doing that, but the video got really tedious because of the amount of calculations. So I'll post a link to that real quick if you have any doubts about how this works, if you want to see some points that are in between, for example. But in this video, I'm going to be really minimalist about it. I'm just going to get the essential points out of this thing so that I can get a sense for what the curve is doing. Finally, at the end, we're asked to compare to a computer algebra system plot. And I actually prepared an animation for this, which gives a way better sense for how the flow of drawing the curve actually goes as theta increases. So let's get started. And what I'm going to assume this time is that you have a basic familiarity with rose curves. And basically, these things look, well, more like daisies than roses. You have sort of teardrop shapes that are called petals. The number of petals depends on the coefficient of theta in the equation. And it's very easy to find the tips of the petals, and that's the approach I'm going to take here. I'm just going to find the tips of the petals, and then I can sketch the entire curve from that. So where do the tips of the petals occur? That's where r has maximum magnitude. And that's going to be 4. It'll correspond to the maxima and the minima of the cosine function. So I start out by saying, okay, what about when 2 theta is equal to 0? That gives me a cosine of 0, and r would be equal to 4. And I've got the tip of my first petal. Now you have to have some experience with these curves before you know exactly what this means. But basically the curve is doing something like this. I want to go to the next time I get a maximum magnitude for r. That's when 2 theta is equal to pi. The cosine of 2 theta is going to be equal to negative 1, so I get r equals negative 4. I should also solve for theta so I can get my polar coordinates here, and theta is pi over 2. Okay, so when I aim straight up, I'm going to walk backwards 4 steps, and I get the tip of my next petal. So I continue this way, and I go to where 2 theta is equal to 2 pi, and r would be equal to positive 4 again, because the cosine of 2 pi is equal to 1, and my angle for theta is going to be pi. So when I'm aiming straight to the left, I go 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces, and I'm at the tip of my third petal. Finally, I go to where 2 theta is equal to 3 pi, and r is going to be 4 times the cosine of 3 pi, which is negative 4 once again, and my angle for theta here is 3 pi over 2. So I aim straight down, and I go backwards 4 steps, and that puts me at the tip of the fourth petal. Okay, so once you recognize that a polar equation is talking about a rose curve, that's all you really need is the tips of the petals, and you're going to get the entire curve. So let's bring in an animation so we can get a really good sense for how this traces out for increasing theta. And I want to point out a couple things in the animation. First, in the prior video on a rose curve with an odd coefficient of theta, it turned out the number of petals was equal to the coefficient of theta. This time we have an even coefficient of theta, the number 2, and it turns out it has twice as many petals as that. So this is an odd fact about rose curves. If they have an even coefficient of theta, you have to double that number to find out how many petals they have. The other thing I want to point out, and it's a related fact, is that the curve is drawn exactly once as theta goes from 0 to 2 pi. When the coefficient was odd, it was actually 2 tracings of the same curve as theta went from 0 to 2 pi. Now we only do it once. That's actually why we end up with more petals. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.